Hello everyone, hope all of you are doing well. My name is Manoj Jindal and currently I am serving as an IAS officer. As a young teenager with millions of dreams and aspirations, have you ever felt confused? Have you ever felt that you are average and will not be able to make the cut? Have you ever felt afraid of the massive challenges that lie right in front of you as you step into the real world after finishing school or college? Once I was a teenager who used to think about all these questions. My unexpected and startling experiences at a very young age made me go through all these. Even though I did not know how to tackle them at that time, I feel over time I have come to understand these situations, and I will tell you four ways to put that confusion to rest and help you find your own way through the maze you are going through, and hopefully help you to turn this into a journey of a lifetime. I had my stint with failure at a very early age in life. When I was in school, I was bullied intensely, which led to a year of depression and confusion. In fact, the longest time, I did not even know that I was actually bullied. The bullying left long-lasting impression on my mind about how I saw the world. After school, I was selected to join the National Defense Academy in Pune. My lifelong dream of joining the armed forces was on the way of being fulfilled. However, at that time, I was still a teenager. I felt confused and unsatisfied with myself, and also unsure whether this was the right thing for me. Eventually, I ended up being medically boarded out after a year in the academy. This was kind of a shock to me. It led to massive confusion in my mind, and I felt I had jumped into the abyss of failure from which I would never be able to recover. I feel many of you will face similar situations in different forms in your life. Some of you might be unsure and confused about your career choices. Some of you might be worried about how to navigate in the real world. And some of you might want to do something which is unconventional, but still you are not sure where to start and how to convince your family and friends. And some of you feel that the world around you does not really understand you, which might even push you into some sort of depression. Well, first of all, I would like to say to all of you, to all the weirdos, to all the dreamers who are out there, who are confused, who might be bullied in the past, or who feel a little depressed, or who have failed at something in the past, it is all right. It is normal to be going through what you are going through right now. There is absolutely nothing wrong in being confused. In fact, it is a very good thing, because being confused means that you are a thinking person who is going through a period of uncertainty. It will make you into a better and a stronger person. And you don't have to feel alone. Don't feel there is anything wrong with that experience of being confused. If you accept the feelings and the state of your mind, you can address it in a better way. It is exactly like experiencing fear and confusion during your first flight. Even the idea of walking across the airport scares and excites us at the same time, but when you go through it, you eventually take the flight. Similarly, when you are depressed, you are dejected, it is partly because you are unsure about what is to come. In fact, one day you will see that everything will make perfect sense. For now, you can laugh at this confusion, you can smile through the tears that you face, and you have to be strong. You have to keep reminding yourself that everything happens for a reason. From my experience, I feel there are four ways you can adopt to fight a failure in your life, or any kind of confusion that might be actually blurring your outlook in life. So the first one is, take a step back and reflect. Reflect about yourself. Often we all forget to take a step back in our life, and we forget to think about what actually brought us where we are. When I was medically boarded out of the National Defense Academy, I actually took a step back from my life and spent an entire month looking back at how I had worked so hard for everything, and nothing could stop me from getting eventually where I wanted to get. But I had to know where I wanted to get. That is the hardest part. Some sort of confusion will always cloud your mind about where you want to get to. But what you need to think about is what got you where you are currently and what will inspire your journey forward. This can be your desire to be in a certain profession that you want to be in, that you find exciting. It could be about developing something on your own. It could be working on a social cause. Keep these broader visions that you have for your life and reflect upon what would get you there eventually. Whether you can apply for a certain academic program or for an internship. Also, reflect upon who you really are, what drives you, where you are in life in terms of the Maslow's hierarchy. Yes, I say that because I use that tool very often in my life to understand whether I am happy or not and what is driving my happiness. Also, try to understand why you do whatever you do, whether it gives you happiness or whether your happiness is actually driven by an Instagram post or is it driven by the quality of life that you're leading. And I really hope that you don't let your happiness be governed by social media. Second, draw up a short-term tangible goal to do something that you want to achieve in all this confusion. Go ahead and follow Mark Manson's brilliant advice, which I often do unknowingly as well. Do something. Just do anything. Most of us actually get stuck when we try to change our lives because we don't know where to start or what to do. This is the most usual question I even get from UPSC aspirants. They ask me how to start the preparation for UPSC. And my advice to them all the time, every time is just start. Wherever you want to start, just do it. You will find your own way. So just stop procrastinating and think that you will get some motivation from an outside source and some deep source within you. So just starting somewhere is one thing that you can do. In fact, Mark Manson's advice is so apparent and so pertinent in this particular thing that I blatantly want to quote from it because it really inspires me. There must be something productive that you must engage yourself in order to feel whole again. If you set yourself a small goal, a small mission to achieve in shorter term, it will fulfill your immediate sense of hollowness in life. At this point, you might not be sure what's your passion in life. In fact, I believe that it is rare to know what's your passion in life. So only after countless experiences over a period of time, you will be able to figure out what drives you every day to wake up and get something done. So please don't feel the burden to find your passion for life right out of the gate. You must just continue to experience life, and with that you will be able to find your passion eventually. Thirdly, please do not care about what other people have to say or what they believe. If you do something or if you want to do something, you obviously can, because even I was told by many people that I could not get into the IAS. Someone told me that my Janam Patri does not have that particular star aligned that I could be in the IAS. My question to the naysayers about what about now? Like Steve Jobs said, your time is limited. So don't waste living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions down you, your own inner voice. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your own heart and your intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. There is always an inner voice that guides us, that knows what we are doing, whether it is right or not. So follow that inner voice. In fact, test out what the inner voice is telling you and move ahead in small steps. And remember, most of our life is a marathon. It's a long, long marathon, which is made up of small races. You need to run that entire marathon, but only one step at a time. You can't sprint the entire thing. You can't go through the entire thing in one go. So be the tortoise that eventually beats the rabbit. But remember, there is no rabbit to beat because all that matters is you. Fourthly, being a management student who has been working to figure out what works and what does not work in business and in policy implementation as an IAS officer, I feel the 80-20 rule or principle really comes to help me. And perhaps it can also help you. So it was Vilfredo Pareto that figured out what is the 80-20 rule when he was gardening. And he noted that every year, 20% of the pea plants in his garden produced approximately 80% of the peas. From this observation, he figured out that in various industries, societies, or in companies, 80% of the production comes from 20% of the most productive portion of those particular industries. Even marketing professionals use this rule to figure out that 20% of their all their customers actually brought 80% of the sales. And I apply this rule to pretty much everything in my life in various situations. How 20% of my time spent doing something actually brings 80% of my happiness and contentment. What is the 20% of the food that I eat 80% of the times? Who are the 20% people who give me maximum 80% happiness in my life? This helps me to figure out which 20% of the things are worth my time and which 20% of the things are not. You could simply use this basic and simple understanding for your in your life to understand the time management and how you want to spend most of your time. So I think life is a constant journey. We are always on the move. Through this journey, we go through many experiences, and it is our attitude, our response to these various events in our lives that really shapes us. I have always believed, do what you want to go through the journey of life and look back at it with fondness and pride or with a little bit of disappointment. And I'm sure that it is the former that you want to think about. So do something or anything. Don't be afraid of whether it is right or wrong way to do it. Just do it. Don't care about what others think. You are the master of your own destiny. And finally, believe in the 80-20 rule. It works. Save your energy and time for the most important things in your lives. These simple but effective rules can truly change your life. I hope this will help you. Thank you.